Hello student, welcome to VASTECH channel. Today I am going to start the unit 2 of module 2, that is second part of module 2, that is nothing but Carnot map or K-map. So here I am taking the help of PDF from Digital Principles and Application by Leach and Malino, along with the other notes. So before proceeding, we should know the sum of Boolean relations, that is A plus B is equal to B plus A. I am not going to explain all those things in detail. Anyway, we know this one. A plus B plus C is equal to bracket A plus B plus C. All these are different types of laws, like cumulative, distributive, associative laws. Then we know A plus 0 is equal to A plus 1 is equal to A plus A is equal to A plus A bar is equal to 1. Then see this relation, A plus A bar B is equal to A plus B. So other than that, so we will try to solve one problem now. The problem is this one. You have to prove this one is zero. So first you multiply this with this, this with this. So now here A into A bar is zero. Leave the other term as it is. Then A bar plus C and this one, C bar. Then multiply with the, this with the, this. Now here, once again, you will get A plus A into A bar. This term becomes 0. So you left with the ACC and this term. Now C into C is nothing but C, that is AC. Once again, multiply with this side, this by this term, then you will get this one, this one. Here once again you have A and A bar, that is 0, and here also C and C bar, that is 0. So finally it becomes a 0. That is the problem you have that's the problem you will solve by using Boolean relations. So we have different method to solve Boolean expression, that is by using Boolean relation. Second one is by using K-map. In K-map you have SOP and POS. Third one is EVM method. Fourth one is Q-map. Fifth one is either by using PLA or PALs, that is nothing but Programmable Logic Device, PLD. So these are the five ways we use to solve Boolean expression. So now we will try to solve one more expression by using Boolean rules. Dear students, you can see simplify y is equal to this one. To simplify this one, I will write above problem statement as it is. Now you take this term, that is A bar B bar plus C bar. Here you treat A bar is equal to A. So what you do? You treat A bar is equal to A. And this one is equal to B, that is B bar plus C bar, you treat as B. Don't confuse, this is separate B and this is A. Now you put this one, you substitute this here under this one. That time this becomes A into B whole bar. What is that according to Boolean, De Morgan's theorem? That is nothing but A bar plus B bar, right? Now what is A bar in our case? What is A in our case? A bar. substitute here. That becomes a bar over that once again bar. And what is b? B is equal to this one. B bar plus c bar once again this one. Now here once again for this you apply De Morgan's theorem. When you apply De Morgan's theorem for this one, you will get BC. I will not repeat that one. Here you will get A, and this one you will get, once again you apply De Morgan's theorem, you will get BC. So this term becomes A plus BC, and this one more term. Now multiply. When you multiply, you will get this one. Now A into A is nothing but A. AB, ABC. B into B is B. B, sorry, BC. Then A this one. Now here take common A inside 1 plus B plus BC. So 1 plus B plus BC is nothing but 1. So how you will get 1 plus B plus BC is equal to 1? 1. Take B is common. When you take B common in the bracket, it becomes 1 plus C. 1 plus C is equal to what? 1 plus C is equal to 1. That becomes 1 plus B. 1 plus B is equal to what? 1. That is nothing but 1. So, this becomes 1. Then remaining A into 1 is A. Then it is A plus BC and followed by this one. Now, write this in other way. A bar plus BC plus BC. Now, we have one rule or relation. That is, we know A plus A bar B. This is nothing but A plus B. Use this one. Now, A bar B. Here, B is nothing but B plus C. That time, this becomes B is nothing but B plus C. That time, it becomes A plus B plus C, BC. Once again, you take common. That time you will get A plus B plus C. So this is the way we will solve our various expression or problem, Boolean expression by using Boolean rules. So my dear students, today onwards I am going to send half an hour file, because it will create a problem to subdivide files for 10 minutes. So anyway, we are going to upload this. I am going to upload this file into YouTube. So now, as I said, there are different ways to solve Boolean expression. So one out of which one method we saw. The second method is a sum of product method. So what is this one? So a product term is any group of literals that are added together. So if you take A and B, then here it is called as literal. A and B is nothing but literals. So the product term that is added, the product term is nothing but any literals that is added together. And sum of that product term is called as SOP. For example, this is fundamental product. And sum of all these terms are called as SOP. You can see here. For example, in this case, we have considered SOP is the expression in which the fundamental product should represent 1 in the output of a truth table. This is the output of a truth table. See here, this is the output of a truth table. In that, whichever term that is 1, that term I have considered, and the sum of which is called as SOP. This is SOP expression. Or the other way of representing this one is y function of three variables, summation m, lowercase m, 3, 5, 6, 7. 3, 5, 6, 7. That is third term, fifth term, sixth term and seventh term. This is called as SOP expression. Now, you can see here, same thing represented by circuit diagram. Here, all these are product terms, finally sum together. So, final resulting expression is called as here SOP, sum of a product, that is called as SOP. Now, dear students, we will take one problem. We will take three variables. We know the combination of three variables are 000, 001 till 111. Now, the fundamental products are 000 you represent by A bar, B bar, C bar. Or I will call this term by M0, lowercase m. 001 I will represent by A bar. 0 means A bar here, B bar, 1 means C, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7. Please remember it starts from M0 till M7, not M1, M0 to M7. Now, output of this one. So, I will put one condition. For even number, output is even number, decimal number, output is 0, and odd number output is 1. For example, this is decimal 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. What I said, for even number it is output is 0, odd number output is 1, even number output is 0, odd number output is 1. Like this we will decide the output. Now, SOP expression is in this one, we have to consider those terms which are giving 1. So, those terms I will consider and I will add it, that gives me SOP expression. So, how to write POS now? POS is nothing but product of a sum. That is nothing but product of a sum term. So, that is represented in uppercase M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7. And those are the term which we can say actually, which represent 0 in the truth table. Those terms which represent 0 in the truth table, and those terms are represented something like this. This is called as fundamental sum. This is fundamental sum. That is 0, 0, you have to put 0, 0, 0 means A plus B plus C. Wherever 1 is there you have to put bar, C bar. Wherever 1 is there, you have to put bar. Here, wherever 0 is there you have to put bar. So, like this. And after that, you represent this in POS format, something like this. This is the POS, product of sum. These are the sum terms which represent 0 in the truth table normally, or 1 in the truth table also, 0 in the truth table. Normally, we will take 0 in the truth table. Then, whose product? So, this is represented by this symbol phi and m, uppercase m, 0th term, 2nd term, 4th term, 6th term. This is the example. SOP represented like this, POS is represented by this symbol. So, in the exam, they need not to tell you. If they give the problem with this symbol, then you should come to know whether it is SOP or POS. So next one is Carnot map, K-map. It is the visual display of fundamental products needed for SOP and POS. Then K-map is used to represent the represent and solve a Boolean expression. Third one is the n variable map will have n rows in the trip table. N variable map will have n rows. For example, if you take two variable, here you can see two rows are there. Three variable, normally three rows. Four variable, four rows are there. Now, K-map is drawn in such a way that each row of the table corresponds to the cell in the map. So now here, this is called as a cell. And this is M0, this is M1, this is M2, this is M3. So this is the way, this is a two variable map. This represents 0, this represents 1. This represents 0, this represents 1. And now A bar, B bar. So M0 is nothing but A bar, B bar, that is M0. M1 is nothing but A bar B. M2 is nothing but A B bar. M3 is nothing but A B. Now K map for 3 variable and K map for 4 variable. We'll see this one. See here, 3 variable. Please follow the standard. For 3 variable, you follow the standard only. For 4 variable, you follow the standard. That means better represent AB here and CD here. That is CD horizontal, AB vertical. Here A vertical, BC horizontal. And here all the cells are adjacent to each other. That means you see here, when you move from here to here, only one variable should change. See, B bar, C bar. This one here, B bar as it is, C bar becomes C. Only one variable changes. When you move from here to here, only one variable changes. When you move from here to here, only one variable changes. That's why B bar C bar, B bar C, B C bar we are not using. If you use B C bar, what happens? B bar becomes B, C becomes C bar. That means two variables are changing. That is not accepted. That's why it is called cells are adjacent to each other. That means you can minimize it. You can minimize it by combining the cells. You can get a minimized expression. So this is K map for a three variable. So here, this is M0, this is M1, this is M2, this is M3, M4, M5, M6, M7. Please remember. Then, K map for 4 variable. So here, C bar, D bar, C, D, C, D, C, D bar, M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7. Then third row is this one, M8, M9, M10, M11, M12, M13, M14 and M15. Is it clear? Is it clear, my dear students? Okay. So now, we will try to solve the problem now. Now, first we will see how to group. Directly I will take the K-map representation and I will try to solve grouping of two ones that is called as pairs. Then grouping of four ones, chords. Then grouping of eight one, oct. So we will see this one and what is the use of grouping of two ones, four ones and eight ones, that we will see. So here in the diagram, you can see here, one and one is given. Directly we are represented. You don't ask me how it has come now. It is one is one here and one here. Grouping of two ones. So when you group two ones, so initially you can solve like this, but once you use K-map, you should not go for this method. You have to directly write the answer. Otherwise, the total meaning of K-map will vanish. So for the first problem, we will go like this. You see this one. Horizontal AB, vertically CD. AB, CD. This one. Horizontal AB, vertical C bar, D bar. Now here, which is common? ABC. D bar. D bar is 1, that means ABC. When you group two ones, one variable will get reduced. That means If you have 4 variable, answer will be 3. If you have 3 variables, answer will be 2. Answer will be 2. If you have 2 variables, answer will be 1. 1 variable, like that. So that is the advantage. Now, here you have to write directly G1, group 1, answer is ABC. You have to see here, this is AB. Here D bar and D will get cancelled, answer is C. Directly you have to write. So now see the second one. See the second one. Here, group of 4 ones. So group of 4 ones. When you group of 4 ones, when you group 4 ones, see, don't group like this. Here possibilities are there that you can group 4 ones. When you group 4 ones, here all the variables will get cancelled. Here answer is AB. So next one is group of 8 ones. When you group of 8 ones, here horizontal all variables will get negated. Vertical here you see B and B bar get negated, you get answer A. That means if you take 4 variable map, if you use 8 ones, then it will get reduced to 1 variable. If you use 4 ones, it will get reduced to 2 variable. And if you use 2 ones, it will get reduced to 3 variable. That means, see, if you use 8 ones, so in this case, you take this case. In this case, instead of going like this, either this way, this way, this way, this way, or instead of going like this, two groups, if you make a single group, you will get this one. One variable. That means to implement this one, you need a simple gate. But to implement, if you use four ones and group, then you will get a somewhat bigger expression that needs more gates. That means if you use this one, grouping of 8 ones, then less hardware is required. So always see whether you can do group of 8 ones. If not possible, see whether you can do group of 4 ones. If not possible, see whether you can make a group of 2 ones. If not possible, then only you take individual. So that is the way. Now here in this diagram you can see, here one group is possible, So what is the answer for G1? G2. Vertically all the variables will get negated, horizontally C bar, D bar. And this one here, you have to consider both vertical and horizontal. Vertically, A bar A get negated, B remains. Horizontally, D bar D get negated, C bar remains. That means you will get B C bar. So finally, you have to add it to get SOP expression. This is called as SOP. So here you see, this is the one group. This is the second group. This is the third group. So you covered all the ones, right? No need to create one more group like this. This is redundant. Why we have to create? I have already created this group. See, by using these three groups, I have covered all ones. So now you see once again, suppose you group like this first. Then you group like this, second. Then you group like this. You will come to know there is a redundancy. So you see whether redundancy is there. This one is covered by this. This one is covered by this. That means redundancy is there. That group is not required. Redundancy group is not required. So here you can see. This is a redundant group that is not required. So what is the alternative way? So thing can do the grouping. This is the first group, this is the second group, this is the third group. Next, here, this is called as rolling the map. Why rolling the map? Because cells are, as when you roll it, cells are adjacent to each other and you can reduce it. So here, this is rolling. So this is actually rolling. This is the one way. Or like this. Or like this. This is the rolling. Or like this. I repeat once again. See here. Rolling. One is this way. Other is this. Third is this one, like this. Four ones you can roll, or eight ones you can roll. Rolling ones, eight ones you can consider. So that is possible. So now we will take the problem and we will try to solve it. So this is the problem. Here you can see, you can make a group of 8 ones, then remaining this alwa. So for this and this, you can make one more group, second group. And this one, this you can create 2 ones, but provision is there for 4 ones. Think that one. Now only one is left. Now I will create 4 ones group like this. See, like this I will create 4 ones group. I repeat once again here. You see, this one, this remaining one, what I will do? I will create 4 ones group. So you have to think like this. Now when you create 4 ones group, what is the answer for this one? Now you see here, this row and this row, this column you have to take. When you take this row, AB, this row, A bar B, which is left? B. That is B. When you take column and this column, which is left? C bar D bar, C D bar. C bar C get negated, D bar left. That is, answer is... B D bar. Let me check once again here. When you take horizontally this and this. This is B bar, right? This is B bar. This is B bar. So answer is B bar D bar. That is the one thing. Now next one here, you see. Here, how many groups are possible? Actually speaking, I have to cover this one. See, I will write here. Don't confuse. Once again, we will draw this one. Here, 1, 2. I will not write variable this one and all. Just to tell you grouping. 1, 2, 3, 4. So now here one is there. 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 Here one is there, here one is there, here one is there, right? Okay, let me change color now. Okay, now grouping. Now see, first I will create this group, one group. Second, I will create one more group, 4 ones. Understood? Two groups are there. Now this one is left. This one I can cover like this, this third group, right? Now this one is left. Here I can't make 4 ones. I can create 2 ones like this one. So how many groups? 4 groups for this one. 4 groups for this one. Here there is no redundant group. 4 groups for this one I have created. So that is the answer. See, is it clear? So my dear students, so with this, I gave introduction to you about SOP. Still, we have to solve so many problems in SOP. So for the time being, I will wind up this video. So thank you.